Hello, Pess.
Hey, Antoine.
How is it going?
Well, I'm just looking the Napoleon grave, you know. We are here in Paris, on the 13th floor of a building. So this kind of floor that doesn't exist in the United States, you know, on the 13th floor. But here in Paris, it is possible that a 13th floor exists. I am Pess. PES, that's my initials, and everybody is calling me like this way.
What does it stand for?
Philippe Emmanuel Sorlin, but everybody is mistaking when they spell or calling my name. So I say PES, PES, like a Pro Evolution Soccer, that everybody remind and can call me that way. That's better. And so I'm running a little edition called Eden Edition. We talk about that after. So
Eden,
voilà. Eden Ung Edition, yeah. Because I always put a word between Eden and Edition, yeah. So I'm living in Paris, and I've got half of my family from very old Parisian family, and the other is kind of half-breed and bastard stuff from Sweden, Swiss, Spain and other stuff, but we don't know. But it's okay. I like to have this half that we don't know very well about that.
Can you tell us about your publication?
Sure, I can. Let me
Yeah,
show
sure.
you. Let me show you. My publication is always when you have in a bookshop, you can. See it very quickly because it is always the same way. They have some brown sleeve always like that. You see, it is a brown sleeve. I put two staple here and here, and I put like that. I can explain because the first book that I made 15 years ago. It was a kind of book on only one edition, and it was when I was in love with some girls. I am very shy, and so I have difficulty to communicate with them, and so I'm making little books, some poetry or some drawings, and
So now you're answering the last question. Why do you make that? So you made that to get some girls.
not to get. It
To seduce.
strangely, it's not to get. It is a kind of a gift of separation's gift. Because when I stop loving her, I'm making I can make some judgment, and I make a little book about, and I'm writing it. It's kind of a death sentence for me. They doesn't know that, but.
And when did you start making?
I think when I was 30, so it was in 96, 97, 99, something like that, the first one. But the first disappear. I didn't have tracks about this
And they were
theme.
unique editions.
Yeah, some of them I always give the master, the original, because most of the time it was kind of a photography, so it was that I rip off from magazine, and so it was original stuff. And so after I decide before to staple it to make some photocopy, and after I can make some copy too. But it's not very. I began to make copy and to make zine beginning of 99 and to 2000. 2000 in the
And
beginning, yeah.
so, did it have the name Eden Edition at this time?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah. It was called Eden Edition because I made comment dire, there's a French writer. It is known a little bit in United States because Bruce Benderson make. The translation does the translation. It's called Pierre Guyotat, and Pierre Guyotat made a book called Eden, Eden, Eden. It was about war and sex, and it's very tough writings, and it shocked me a lot. And And it was my favorite writer at this time. He's still alive today. And so I wanted to make a baptism of my first edition of Eden Edition, thinking of this book. Mm-hmm. Most of the time, my books are anonymous. There are no right. I never sign. There are only some edition, and I have begun to call it Eden Edition because I suppose it was a kind of discreet. And it doesn't have importance. Who did that for me? Mm-hmm. And after, from 10 years ago now, from 2005 and 2008, I've made some meetings of friends, and I want to make zine about what they're doing. And so I began to make another zine, not from myself, but from people that I love and mm-hmm. I care.
Collaboration,
yeah, mm-hmm. and in collaboration, not so many, because collective. I've made some collective issue, but it's always very. You must phone all the people, and they are all. Everybody's late, and with 2 months later, we can delay from 2 months, mm-hmm. and nobody's ready.
It's easier to work alone.
There's something in one night. You can make a zine in one night, mm-hmm. so there's something very fast. I can reckon some speed but you take a sketchbook and you write a poem, you are in the underground, so and you have your poem, it's very quickly, mm-hmm. and so the zine, it is the same way a little bit. You can put some photo and you put some text, and you have your zine. I like this kind of.
What type of content can we find in your publication?
There are some obsessive stuff, and there are some. I've got a kind of a review called Clark Gable Stock Exchange inside my edition, and this one is kind of magazine, and it is like mixed pickles. So you have a poem, you have an article from a newspaper. And you have photographies that I don't make. I've got photographies that I make, some drawings drawings from other people that I know or people that I don't know. Schemes, very difficult to say in English. Excuse my French, like say when you say in the Western, Hollywoodian Western movie. Excuse my French for saying so, because my
why
English
is it called Clark Gable?
Because it's like a Jamaican singer in Jamaica. There are Clint Eastwood and Charlie Chaplin and some people like that, like Bruce Lee too. And I think it was very funny from this Jamaican singer to take the name, very famous name, so mm-hmm. everybody can remind it. And so I said, oh, sir, I do the same. So my name is Clark Gable, and I make my little magazine called Clark Gable Stock Exchange. Because I'm doing some music, it happens that I make some concert, and my solo name is Clark Gable too, you know. Okay. Voilà. And
you prepared some stuff about the people that you love,
yeah,
that
love,
inspired you.
The first one, it is a very old friend of me. It's very old too. It's called André Labarthe. I made several books, like 5 books. He made some bad drawings when he was on the phone. And so it was a very shitty drawings. And it was very funny. And I said, oh, let's do it a zine with that. It's so bad. It's so bad drawing. So André Labarthe was a very, very close friend. I like him. He showed me a lot of things about Paris and about meeting people. It's very important to me. There are other people too, like Hendrik Aigret, or Olivier Bringer, or some other people, Evary Vox too. There are all of some friends that I make some zine too.
And they are sort of the old school of French zines. For example, Hendrik, he's the creator of Nazi Knife.
Nazi Knife, absolutely. I've made perhaps 4 or 5 books with him, like this one, for example. I've got take one this one. It's called Art Classic, and like very beautiful drawing. I like that. It's good. And most of the time, I like to have some Minerva. It is called. It is a orange regular. And so you can put some drawing inside to have some classical name. But it's very. Most of the time, I'm perhaps a little drunk, and so it's not very very bad. It's bad nice, but it's okay. I think for this time it's okay. He makes some portrait of Dürer, very very good. Portrait of Albrecht Dürer, very very funny. So I like that.
And so you're also a filmmaker. Can you tell us about the relationship between what you do as a zine maker and? And the inspiration that you draw from cinema?
Most of the there are several occasions. For example, when I have made a project to making a picture, I made a little zine of that. All the sketchbook and the notes and the drawing, like the storyboard or the stills of location, and I've made. Three or four, five zine with all my notes about this movie. But I've made some script too, because for giving to a producer, it is better to have some pictures and you can read the story with this kind of support, you know. And so I made that too. And most of the time, it reminds me Fellini, Federico Fellini, an Italian movie maker. And when he was old, he don't have all the money that he want, and so he have some notebook. He have some notebook, and he make his pictures like that. And and most of the time in my edition, I've write I don't know the name, Abraxas Blue Hotel, a film by. An edition, and it's a kind of movie for me. It's because it is narrative. It is always important for me to get some narrative content inside my zine. You have a beginning, a middle, and the end. So there are some evolution between a man and a woman. They get together, they make love. He come, and there are a huge explosion, and after he die, or something like that. There are a lot of I use, but it's very important for me to make to invent it, some stories, a little story inside. Yes, yes.
And can you tell us about Les Cahiers du Cinéma?
Yeah. Okay. Because when I was when I was 11 or 12, I say okay, I want to make pictures, and I still want it, Like Pollock say, what we can do when we're not making picture. Like he say, what we can do when we're not making painting, and it is the same. So I'm making zine. When I don't make pictures, I'm making zine. And so the first collage, because I'm making some collage, and the first collage. It is a very very famous Cahier du Cinéma, the 300, and it is made by Godard. From 79, and inside there are several collages, and one is incredible. It is this one.
So the whole issue is designed by Godard.
Design, and he wrote all the stuff practically. There are some letters, and you see, like there are some. I'm doing this kind of zine. It is practically the same for me. You see, little picture and a text, and a bigger one. And this one, it's incredible, huge, because it's Hitchcock with some people showing their ass, and Ingrid Bergman, and there are another here. It is here, ça va, on voit bien là, comme ça.
Perfect.
And Kim Novak, and he say, oh, last night I've seen a movie of Hitchcock. I've seen Vertigo last night on the movie, and I say, oh, that's incredible, because Hitchcock finally. he filmed a face like us. And that's why he likes a face who looks like us. Very, very curly, curly face. And so that's the idea
curly,
for
curly,
he makes a collage.
Curly.
Curly, non, rond, très rond. Curly, c'est bouclé.
Ouais.
Rond.
Curvy.
Curvy, curvy face, absolutely. And he's doing this sign. Filmer les visages,
yeah.
Comme il essaie, filmer les visages comme des culs, quoi. Filming face like asses.
Can you show us the last piece that you prepared?
Sure,
that
sure.
Is maybe your first zine.
Oh yeah, I was 11 probably, and there was comment j'adore ce mot en plus. Comment on dit un grenier?
An attic.
An attic, attic of my grandmother in the south of France. And I make some
so are those the dirty pictures of your grandmother?
Yeah, from New Look. No, it came from Louis, Playboy, and the old magazine from the 70s and from the 80s too, because it's very airy, so it's 80. It's 80 stuff, because after the 90s, air disappears. And so I made and when I buy to go to Tallinn or to Saint Petersburg, I buy some pornographic magazine and I make some drawings.
So that was your first collection.
Oh yeah, absolutely, absolutely, yeah, yeah. Because like I said, I'm very shy, and so of course, I've got some adventure with girls, but not so many. And this kind of it's for me, because I'm not very good in drawing, and I've done some zine with porno stuff inside, and it is only drawings and porno, and because I don't know how to draw, I use a calc. We say calc, no?
Tracing paper.
Tracing paper, absolutely. So I use tracing paper on this kind of magazine,
mm-hmm.
And I made a lot of zine like that, because Jacques Noël from Regard Moderne. First time when I came to take some Hendrik invited me there,
mm-hmm.
And they say, oh, but there's some drawing, but there are not so many tits and boobs and booties, there are not so many, I don't take it. I say, oh, okay, you want some zine with okay, I can do it. So I make a specialized
so they weren't dirty enough to be sold at Le Regard Moderne.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay.
And it's called a série called House of Earth, House of Cream. Also, that's my series pornographic, mm. With only drawing, and I made another series with pictures from bondage from the 50s,
mm-hmm.
And it's kind of it's look like it's similar to your work too, because it's reprinting
mm-hmm.
Of old stuff of catalog from the 50s, but specialized in bondage or spanking. There are some. And everybody is not naked. There are some clothes on it. Very not so many, but there's the combinatoire, the combination of people. It's very interesting, because it's very inventive. Very inventive. Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
And so, Pes, what is important in what you do, and why do you do that?
I do that because. I can't help it to do that.
Mm-hmm.
I have got a real emergency to do that. If I have got some love affair and situation, and so I can't make zine during 1 month or 2 months. But when I am alone, I am always very like I am a bachelor, and so I make a lot of zine when I am bachelor. And but it's a real urge, because it's a kind of emergency, yeah. Because I try to waste this kind of action. I say I do it that all the time. I must do it and one more, and after I will be fed up of that. And from that time I'm not fed up with this kind of zine. So for this time I've made I think 120. I'm on 110 and 120, because like I told you in the beginning, there's a lot of zines that I didn't remember, and they are gone forever or something like that. Voilà.
Cool.
Voilà.
Well, thank you so much.
C'est pas mal.